It's time for The Mix at 6. Counting down the top hip-hop and R&B songs in the country. The Mix 88.9. Lynchburg's number one station for hip-hop and R&B. Soul and reggae.
Shock the system. For life.
What's going on, my good people? It is Friday. We made it. We made it to the end of the week. You made it. You did it. You made it to the end of the week. I'm sure that it's been a long week. It has been a stressful week. But that's all over now because it is time for the weekend. And isn't that what we all work for? Everybody's working for the weekend. It is 6 o'clock. I am Khalil Creed. This is The Mix at 6. And we are all here at Lynchburg's number one source for hip-hop and R&B and soul and reggae. The Mix 88.9 for another hour of me bringing you the top six hip hop hits in the land. If you are new here, welcome. Welcome to the family. That's what we are. We are a family. We are a family that is understanding and caring, and your opinions are all valid here. We can agree to disagree, but that's as far as it'll go. It'll all get done out of love, and we will move forward, and everything will be peachy keen. I don't even know what that means. I don't know what. Somebody tell me what peachy keen means, where it came from. I'm sure I could Google it, but that's a lot of work right now. I'm trying to get through this Friday. Speaking of today, speaking of Fridays, tonight, in just a couple of hours, we will be at Bull Daddy's Restaurant and Bar in Appomattox, Virginia. I will be there. DJ Benjamin It will be there. DJ Cool V will be there. It's going to be hosted by DJ H. Vidal. It's going to be a situation. It's going to be a dope situation. Ladies, you're free before 10. So come on out to Bull Daddy's Restaurant and Bar. Hang out with the crew. Meet the crew, meet the personalities, meet the talent of the Mix 88.9, because you're getting a good chunk of it there. You'll get a good chunk of it there. So I'll see y'all there. And when you get there, tell me that you heard this on my show. So I heard you tell us to come out here to tell me that that's how you found out about it. So we can take a selfie together. We can get a selfie. We can post a selfie together. It'll be a good time. We're gonna have fun. We have fun regardless, but I want you involved. I want you involved in the shenanigans. So, Bull Daddy's Restaurant and Bar, Appomattox, Virginia. Ladies, you're free before 10. Come out and have a good time. Today has been a good day. And I know y'all kind of hear that from me a lot, but lately, I have nothing to complain about. Like, there are minor situations, but that's always. There's always going to be like little minor situations. But overall, today was a good day, as Ice Cube would say. But what I do want to address is the comments I made yesterday about Jussie Smollett. Some people weren't happy with what I had to say about him and how I feel like he should be in jail and how I felt like he preyed on the fears of black people who are actually getting attacked. He preyed on the fears of LGBTQ individuals who were getting attacked. And he made it about himself for a very selfish reason. And he should be in jail. You know, but some more stuff came out, and we'll talk about it later. But I meant what I said. I do not care. It is crazy to me that if this situation was reversed, if a white guy said two black people attacked him, and it was clearly false. It was clearly false. He was found guilty in court. He was sent to jail and let out after 6 days. Y'all would lose your mind. Y'all would lose your mind. Facebook would melt down. TikTok would melt down with y'all pointing fingers at all kind of documents and conspiracy theories and all kind of stuff. Instagram, Twitter, it would all cease to exist if something like that happened. So why is it different now? Explain that to me. Make that make sense. Why is it different now? Because he's black? No, that's what we're fighting against. We're actively fighting against things like this happening. And y'all are sitting here defending this dude as though he's right. As though he's right. And he is not. So, like I said, I hope karma come for him. I hope karma get him. And I hope that he get more time in jail, because that's a possibility also. But you're not here for that. You're here for the Mix of Six. I am Khalil Creed, your host. And we're going to go ahead and hop into this number six song. Here is Ari Lennox with Pressure. Here on Lynchburg's number one source for hip-hop and R&B, soul, and reggae, The Mix 88.9. And you're listening to The Mix at 6, here with me, your host, Khalil Creed, and we are here at Lynchburg's number one source for hip-hop and R&B, soul, and reggae, The Mix 88.9, and that was our number six song, Ari Lennox with Pressure. Now, we're going to start off the entertainment portion, well, the entertainment news portion, with a couple of sad stories, so just stick with me. Condolences to the Braxton family. Tracy Braxton has passed away from esophageal cancer. She died on Saturday. She was 50 years old, and she died with family and friends by her side. They knew that it was going to happen. And she went on Saturday. Then they released a tribute video for Tracy. And here is a snippet.
Tracy!
What will come out of Tracy's mouth?
Who's to say?
He grabbed a good chunk of my awesome.
What did I get myself into? And here's the moment of truth.
I'm very protective over my sisters.
I don't do anything for my sisters.
I'm gonna get this.
First Braxton family great grandbaby.
I'm just gonna relax and be Tracy.
Just sad all around. Sad all around. You hate to see it. But of course, you know, from us here at the Mix 88.9 and me personally, we send all the condolences we can to the Braxton family. All the positive energy that I can send from this chair behind this microphone, I do so. And I hope for healing. Another bit of sad news, Pusha T and No Malice of the Clips, their brothers, their father passed away. Here recently after their mother passed away this past November. So that's a hard piece of business. But I've heard of that happening from a long-term marriage. Once one dies, the other dies soon afterwards because they're so connected. That's the kind of love that I want one day. That's the kind of relationship I want to be in, where we're connected, you know, so deeply. You know, you can't break a bond like that. But again, healing energy and positive energy, and all the condolences to Pusha T and No Malice for the loss of their father and also their mother this past November. I didn't even know about that part. So, but let's bring the mood up a little bit. Let's talk about Shaq. Shaq talks about one of the worst business decisions that he has made while he was on the Earn Your Leisure podcast. Here's what he had to say.
So my agent calls me up and he says, Howard Schultz wants to do business with you. And I'm like, coffee? Because growing up in my household, never seen a black person drink coffee. So it was my thought process that black people didn't drink coffee. You know, we always used to see the commercials, fill it to the rim with brim. We used to see the commercials, but in my house, it was always sweet tea, hot chocolate.
This was kind of surprising to me to hear that a lot of people a lot of black people didn't grow up with coffee. My parents drank coffee. My mom drank coffee all the time. Every morning she drank coffee, so I was well aware of coffee. It was gross. I never liked it. I tried it as an adult a couple of times. It just wasn't for me. I like hot tea. I'll take hot tea or hot chocolate or something like that. All of those were also accessible, but I had never heard of it not being a, I guess it surprised me that it wasn't a everybody thing. That just seemed normal to me to smell coffee in the morning. I didn't think it was a cultural thing. I just thought it was a thing that grown-ups did, and then a gross thing that grown-ups did. So I don't know, but apparently coffee's good for you. I couldn't tell you because I don't drink coffee, but a million Starbucks can't be lying. Like, they y'all be fiending for that coffee. Y'all be acting out for that coffee. I know people who can't function, let's say, drink coffee in the morning. So I don't know. I've never been down that rabbit hole, and I don't intend to go. I'm not a fan of it. Like I said, I've tried it. I've tried it with the different creamers. I've tried it with, you know, sugar. I've tried it. You know, it's not bad. It's not the worst thing, but I just couldn't see myself doing it every morning. I can't see myself doing it all the time. Some people drink coffee at night, which is bananas to me. I have a friend, my friend Gene, he drinks coffee at night. I'm like, isn't that a stimulant? Isn't it a stimulant to keep you up and to keep you going? And he drinks it at night like a mad lad. But I don't know. And he's not the only one that I know that does that, that drinks coffee at night. But I don't know. Some people say it helps them sleep. I don't see how. That's not how caffeine works. But whatever works for you. Whatever works for you. If you like it, I love it. I just... Not a fan. And I tried. So I gave it a try. And it's not... I'm not on board. I'm not a fan. But what I am a fan of is this countdown. I am a fan of this music that I bring to you. So let's go ahead and hop back into it. Here is our number 5 song. Here is SZA with I Hate You. Here on The Mix at 6, I, of course, am your illustrious host, Khalil Creed, and we are all here at Lynchburg's number one source for hip-hop and R&B, soul, and reggae, The Mix 88.9. And you're listening to The Mix at 6. I am Khalil Creed, and we are all here at Lynchburg's number one source for hip-hop and R&B, soul, and reggae, The Mix 88.9. And that was our number 5 song, SZA with I Hate You. Kylie Jenner, she said she's struggling after the birth of her son. This is her second child with Travis Scott. She's struggling with postpartum depression. And this is something that us dudes will never know anything about. We will not know the struggle of this, and we will not know what these ladies and phenomenal women are going through once they give birth to these children. All we can do is support them. All we can do is be there. All we can do is try to be understanding, but we will never truly know what they're going through. But she posted a series of videos to her Instagram Live, and here's what she had to say.
This experience for me personally has been a little harder than with my daughter. It's not easy mentally, physically, spiritually. We can go on the internet and it might look a lot easier for other people and like put the pressure on us, but it hasn't been easy for me either. And it's okay not to be okay. Once I realized that, I was putting some pressure on myself, and I just keep reminding myself I made a whole human, beautiful, healthy boy, and we have to stop putting pressure on ourselves to be back, not even physically, just mentally.
And she's right. Take the pressure off yourself. It's okay. The world's gonna keep spinning. Tomorrow's gonna come. No pressure, no worries. Get some of that stress off yourself. Take care of yourself if you need to. If you need to take a break, take a break. If you need to go talk to somebody, go talk to somebody. Find you somebody you can talk to if you can't afford a therapist. But whatever you do, do not hold all that in and try to shoulder all of that responsibility, because it will break you down physically. It will break you down mentally. It can kill you. And we don't want that. There's always been this stigma, and I've talked about this before, but it's very important. Mental health is very important to me. Taking care of your mental health is very important to me. It's always been this stigma that, you know, it's weak to ask for help. It's weak to go talk to somebody. It's weak to share your feelings. It's not. It's really not. It can save your life. It can help you get all of that negative energy out, all of those negative feelings out. Talk to somebody. Bounce what you're thinking off of someone else. Maybe you are just being irrational. Maybe you're just, you know, overthinking something. Maybe it's not that big of a deal, or maybe it is a big deal, but you got to figure it out. And two heads are better than one. You got to figure it out. So it's fine. I am a huge advocate of mental health. If you are going to see a therapist, if you're doing group therapy, single therapy, whatever kind of therapy you are doing, I am in your corner. I am on your side. I support you 1,000,000%, because you're taking care of your mental health. You can't give to other people. You can't take care of other people if you don't take care of yourself mentally. And you women who go through this postpartum depression, I've just heard horror stories, so I'll never know what it truly means to go through that, or how it feels to truly go through that. But you know, all we men can do is support you. And fellas, we got to do our part. Don't get mad at her for, you know, mood swings or whatever comes along with it. You got to support her. You know, she pushed your big head child out. The least you can do is support her while she's trying to deal with the after effects of it. But, you know, I'm just talking right now because I don't know a lot about postpartum depression. But mental health is very important. Take care of your mental health. Take care of it. Mike Tyson is launching. I saw this on Facebook and I don't know if it was real or not, but it's real. He's launching Mike Bites. These are ear-shaped edibles. Ear-shaped gummies that are edibles. And the ears have a bite taken out of them already. Now, for those who don't know, and why that's hilarious, is Mike Tyson, in 1997, Mike Tyson bit a chunk of Evander Holyfield's ear off during their boxing match. Like, literally bit him. Then bit him again and bit a part of his ear off. And Mike pitched this idea to Evander Holyfield when he was a guest on Mike Tyson's podcast, Hot Boxing. And so now it's a real thing. I saw a picture of him, and it's hilarious. It's how you make money, because that's Mike Tyson is known for a lot of things, but I think that he's more known to the younger generation as the guy that bit the other guy's ear. So this is genius marketing. So it's hilarious. It's hilarious. If I can get my hands on some, I definitely will. I need to find somebody who has access to a dispensary. I don't do edibles or get high or anything like that, but I just want a packet of them because it's funny to me. So if anybody can get me a pack of those, I would really appreciate it. But let's get back into the music, because that's why we're here, right? We're not here to talk about Mike Tyson ear bitten gummies, even though it's hilarious. You know it's funny. You know it's funny. But let's get back into the music. Let's get into this number 4 song. Here is Papoose featuring Lil Wayne, 2 Chainz, Remy Ma, and Busta Rhymes. Thought I was going to stop? The remix. Here on The Mix at 6, here at Lynchburg's number 1 source for hip-hop and R&B, soul, and reggae, The Mix 88.9. And you're listening to The Mix at 6. I am your host, Khalil Creed, and we are here at Lynchburg's number 1 source for hip-hop and R&B, soul, and reggae, The Mix 88.9. And that was our number 4 song, Papoose, featuring Lil Wayne, 2 Chainz, Remy Ma, and Busta Rhymes. Thought I Was Gonna Stop, the remix. Now, when I say the name Ruth E. Carter, what does that mean to y'all? Have y'all ever heard of Ruth E. Carter? Well, if you haven't heard of her, you have certainly seen her influence in movies. They have a display in Roanoke. As a matter of fact, I went to it earlier today with Danelle. Me and Danelle went. She asked me a few weeks ago, well, she told me about it a few weeks ago, and I was like, I'm super down. She sent me the advertisement for it, and I kind of just invited myself, but I wasn't gonna miss it. She didn't mind. She tolerates me, and that's what's important. But we had a good time. We had fun. We went up there to the display. It's called Ruth E. Carter, Afrofuturism and Costume Design. And it's going to be there until April 3rd. And what it is she is behind some of the most iconic costumes that you've seen on film. I don't think costumes is the word, but wardrobes in films that you have definitely seen, like stuff you wouldn't even think of, stuff that was super duper dope to me, all the way down to the LeBron James, the Fortnite jacket he wore with the two, I think they're wolves or lions on the shoulders they did for Fortnite. That's on display there also. But stuff like the coat from Shaft, like Shaft's coat, she designed that. I'm Gonna Get You Sucker. Remember when Fly Guy got out of jail and he had the fish in the shoes and the whole outfit? That whole outfit is on display there. It even has, well, it's fake fish, but it has fish in the shoes of the outfit. It's just super duper dope. Then she did the wardrobe for Malcolm X, the movie Malcolm X with Denzel Washington. She has the suits that Denzel and Spike Lee wore when they went out dancing in the very beginning. Dolomite Is My Name, the Eddie Murphy one, and the original Rudy Ray Moore one. All the costumes are there. The wardrobe is there from that. Coming to America, the first one and the second one. What else? Oh, Do the Right Thing. Do the Right Thing. They have Radio Raheem's, the brass knuckles he had, and they have the boombox and the clothes that they wore. Like all the wardrobes and stuff. It's fun to go and try to guess what movie is from without looking at the little placard. That's what I was trying to do a few times, but you can't avoid it sometimes. But it's super dope. And then they have Black Panther. They have all the wardrobe from Black Panther, and you can take pictures. I got pictures of everything, and it's super dope. Like M'Baku, Black Panther, Okoye, Forrest Whitaker's character, Killmonger, when he was in the museum with just a jean jacket on, they have that whole outfit. Angela Bassett's outfit, the Dora Milaje outfit. Like, it's just, all of it is on mannequins on display. It's in Roanoke. It'll only take you probably about 15 minutes to walk through the whole thing, but it was definitely a good time. Me and her had a blast. But yeah, I took pictures of everything that was there. And I'll post them on my Khalil Creed page. I'll put them on the Mix 88.9 page also, just so y'all can see what I'm talking about as far as this display goes. But yeah, it was super duper dope. I'm glad I went. She had been talking about it, and I just thought it would be fun to see the Black Panther costume up close. You can't touch it. I wanted to touch it, but it's up on a display, and the little security lady would have probably tackled me, but I want one now. But anyway, let's get back into this music. Let's get into this number 3 song. Here is Doja Cat featuring SZA, Kiss Me More, here on The Mix at 6, here on Lynchburg's number 1 source for hip-hop and R&B, soul and reggae, The Mix 88.9. And you're listening to The Mix at 6. I am your host, Khalil Creed, and we are all here at Lynchburg's number 1 source for hip-hop and R&B, soul and reggae, The Mix 88.9. And that was our number 3 song, Doja Cat featuring SZA, Kiss Me More. Fabulous says he had an issue with a DoorDash driver. Says the DoorDash driver went to his car and stole him and his son's shoes and clothes. Yeah, I said that right. I don't know what I thought I just said, but yeah, that's what happened. The DoorDash driver went in Fabulous's car after he delivered his food and stole his son's shoes and clothes. He says if the driver returns the items, he won't press any charges. This is wild to me. Like, why would you attempt something like this, being the DoorDash driver, knowing that someone like Fabulous or someone in a big house like Fabulous wouldn't have cameras? Like, why do people... I don't know why people don't think or use their heads when they do stuff. If you don't do crime, be good at doing crime. If you ain't good at doing crime, don't do it. Don't do crime. If you're not good at doing crime, don't do crime. You shouldn't do crime anyway, but if you're not good at it, definitely don't do it. So hopefully this driver returns the items, because Fabulous has his name. He has the DoorDash information. It tells you all of that when the people bring your food. It tells you who they are, what they look like, what they drive, and their car information. It tells you all of that. So he has all your information, and you want to pull something like this when he has cameras everywhere. It's just not a smart way to go about doing things. So hopefully the guy returns the stuff, and it really is no harm, no foul, but we will see. Steve Harvey was on the Earn Your Leisure podcast. He discussed creating the show that led to America's Got Talent. Steve had a show back in the 90s called Steve Harvey's Big Time, and here's actually what he had to say about it.
Y'all ought to take Showtime at the Apollo and put it on mainstream TV instead of having me come on at 1 o'clock in the morning. I used to tell them that. Yeah. No, you can't do that. No. So I said, well, let me give them a version of it. Along comes the show called America's Got Talent.
He's gonna say that, yep.
Look, man, the first year of America's Got Talent was all acts from Steve Harvey's Big Time. And they took all the producers I had from Steve Harvey's Big Time and gave them jobs. If I understood my business, America's Got Talent would belong to me.
I cannot imagine having a multi-million dollar idea like that and then it be told no to me, and then to see my idea on TV years later, well, decades later, but still, to see what I came up with be actually brought to fruition when I was decades ahead of my time, that has to hurt. But Steve Harvey is a creative mind. He is a forward thinker who can, you know, see this kind of stuff before it comes. Some people are just ahead of their time, and it just happens. Like, some people just are on that level where they got ideas. They're idea people. So, you know, I'm sure he's had 1,000 of those kinds of ideas happen, come and go. Some of us can't get one, and he just spit them out like it's nothing. But good on him. You know, he landed, I think he did okay. He landed into something else, and I think he did all right. Zendaya's father was doing an interview, and he discussed being there for his daughter and his goal for, you know, being a father of a famous actress.
We don't know how long we're going to be there for our children. So you want your children to be independent of you and to make their own choices, to be informed so that they can make the right choices. So one thing I learned about this industry, they don't want to work with a busybody, mouthy parent that's in the way. Mm-hmm. So I let Zendaya speak for herself, and I want her to be an entrepreneur that can see all the different businesses that come out of her career, and I want her to own those businesses and learn from the brilliant minds that I surround her with.
I could not have said that any better myself. I am a proud girl dad, as you all know. There's nothing I love more than bragging about my girls, but I also want my girls to be independent. I want my girls to be able to make their own decisions. I want my girls to be able to stand on their own 2 feet. I want my girls to not have to depend on any man for anything. If they have a man, it's because they choose to have a man, not because they need to have a man. And that's what I like to instill in my girls. I like to let them know that they're beautiful. I like to let them know that they are worth it and that they are never less than. That they are to be treated as princesses and queens and all of that. And if anybody can't do that, then they are not worth their time. I like to talk to them about the kind of guys to avoid. I let them know that they're gonna make mistakes. You know, it's a part of the growing up process, but daddy's always gonna be here. I'm always gonna be in their corner. So I could not have said that any better than the way he said it. I think that's an excellent way to go about doing things. I think it's a successful formula because Zendaya is a very successful young lady, young woman, and I don't see anything wrong. So salute to him, salute to that father. I am glad to be in the ranks of girl dad. And of course, you know, I'm just a dad because I have a son too, but I'm most proud of my girls. They're growing up to be fine young ladies. Especially my oldest one, my Jada. She is growing up so fast and she is doing big girl stuff now, and it's breaking my heart because she's not going to need me anymore. But anyway, let's get back into this music. Let's get into this number two song. Here is Pusha T with Diet Coke here on the Mix at 6 here at Lynchburg's number one source for hip hop and R&B, soul and reggae, The Mix 88.9. You're listening to The Mix at 6 here on your number one source for hip-hop and R&B, soul and reggae, The Mix 88.9. And I am Khalil Creed, and that was our number two song, Pusha T with Diet Coke. Just a reminder, tonight, Let's Grow Fridays at Bull Daddy's Restaurant and Bar in Appomattox, Virginia. I will be there. DJ Benjamin It will be there. DJ Cool V will be there. DJ H Vidal will be there. And I just found out the one and only Ray Daniels will be there also. It's going to be a good night. Come out and meet some of the Mix 88.9 personalities, DJs, mix masters, talent, all around talent we got going on over here. We're all going to be at Bull Daddy's. Ladies, you're free before 10. Free before 10, ladies. Free before 10. Bull Daddy's Restaurant and Bar in Appomattox, Virginia. We're going to be there. Hope to see you there too. Also, you ever thought about sponsoring? You ever thought about sponsoring a segment? Sponsoring one of our shows? Sponsoring the station? We have options for you. We have variety for you. We have something that can fit you. If you are interested, please email us at themix8991@gmail.com. That's themix8991@gmail.com, and we will get that information out to you. But speaking of sponsors, let's take a second to thank some of them before our number one song.
Promotional consideration paid for by the following.
And you are listening to The Mix at 6 here on Lynchburg's number one source for hip-hop and R&B, soul and reggae, The Mix 88.9. And that was our number one song, Young Blue and Kalani, Beautiful Lies. What's also beautiful is that this week is over with. We are done here, but I will be back here on Monday, and I hope you are too, and I hope you bring some friends. Help me spread the word. Let people know to download the app. They can go to their Google Play or Apple App Store, search The Mix 88.9. Let them know that I am here Monday through Friday, 6 p.m. to 7 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. They can follow us on social media, Facebook and Instagram, The Mix 88.9, and on Twitter, The Mix 8991. If you want to follow me, you can. Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, Twitch, Discord. I am on all the things under one name, Khalil Creed DB. If you miss any part of this episode or you want to catch up on past episodes, I got you covered. Go on over to my YouTube page, The Fortress of Awesometude. That's AweSomeTude. Go to my playlist, click Vibe Club, and they're all there for your consumption. Don't forget to subscribe and click the bell so you're notified when I upload videos. This episode goes live at 7 o'clock on YouTube as well as over on Facebook. So if you missed any of the show, you can check them out over there. But I'm done for the week. I am out of here. Up next is the Talk of New York, DJ Kid New and the Recovery Room. Again, I am Khalil Creed. This is The Mix at 6. I will see you all here on Monday. Have a safe weekend. And we are all here at Lynchburg's number one source for hip-hop, R&B, soul, and reggae, The Mix 88.9.